Those are the visuals of the aggrieved family, understandably absolutely distraught. This incident coming from Greater Noida. 23-year-old girl who was an engineer, she was allegedly bludgeoned to death by her husband along with her in-laws. She was found lying in a pool of blood and she was rushed to the hospital, and that is where she was declared brought dead. Now, according to this girl's father, the husband was demanding 10 lakh rupees as well as a car as dowry. So far, an FIR under Section 302, that is murder, and sections of the Dowry Act has been registered against the husband along with his family. The police have arrested the husband and his parents, but his sister is still on the run. Those visuals on your television screens of the aggrieved family. We have got more reactions on this story. Let's listen in to some of them.
ये बहुत जबरदस्त हॉल सब है और पूरा बदन ही ब्लड से पूरा सना हुआ है।
तो ठीक है, आपको क्या लग रहा है किस चीज से हत्या की होगी, किस
तरीके का? पोस्टमार्टम के बाद ही पता चल पाएगा। पूरा बॉडी
बॉडी में और भी जगह चोटे थी क्या?
और पूरा ब्लड ही लगा हुआ है, तो अब ये तो सिनेक्ट करना था उसे ही नहीं पता चल पा रहा है, मगर सर में चोट बहुत ज्यादा है।
हमारी ये बिटिया जो थी रिचा, हमारे दोस्त हैं, डेंसो में काम करते हैं, उनकी बिटिया की शादी अभी 2 साल पहले हुई थी अल्फा सेकंड में। काफ़ी जो है दहेज भी दिया था इन्होंने, लगभग 30 लाख के करीब खर्चा लड़की वालों को दिया था, बाकी 10-15 लाख रुपए और भी ऊपर से खर्च किया था
जी।
लड़की जो है पढ़ी लिखी है, वो करीब 40,000 रुपए तनख्वाह उसको मिल रही है, विप्रो में यहीं ग्रेटर नोएडा में जॉब कर रही है। और सबसे बड़ी दिक्कत यही थी कि वो लड़का जो है कुछ कमाता नहीं था, और उसको यही जलन थी कि हमारा लड़की जो है इतना कमा रही है, उसको फ्रस्ट्रेशन रहता था। लड़की के साथ मारपीट बताते हैं, उसके भाई ने बताया, लड़की के ने कि उसके साथ मारपीट करते थे ताले।
अपूर्वा जॉइनिंग अस ओवर द फोन लाइन। अपूर्वा, दिस इज अ शॉकिंग इंसिडेंट बिकॉज दिस इन्वॉल्व्स एन एजुकेटेड वुमन हु वाज एन इंजीनियर। शी वाज वर्किंग इन अ रिनाउंड कंपनी। शी वाज ब्लडजन्ड टू डेथ बाय हर ओन हस्बैंड एंड हर इन-लॉज सिंपली बिकॉज शी वाज नॉट बीइंग एबल टू पे द अमाउंट दे वर आस्किंग हर टू पे।
Absolutely, Urvashi, it is extremely shocking to say the least, and the manner in which this entire crime has come to light certainly is another shocking incident there. But more importantly right now, a couple of details are coming out when we were also speaking to the family members. First and foremost, this girl was extremely accomplished. She was working in a private MNC here in Greater Noida, while both the husband and wife, who just got married 2 years back, both of them were engineers. It seems the boy was not really successful in all his ventures, and perhaps that was one feeling that was always there, a kind of inferiority complex as well, of how his wife was doing really well while he hasn't been able to reach much in life. But then, having said that, the kind of demands that have also come in terms of a car, a Scorpio car recently, with almost 10 to 12 lakhs being asked by the family members. We also spoke to the friend of this victim, to whom she has literally confided every single thing, because she wasn't opening up to her father, which is what the father was also saying. And when we spoke to the friend, there were details that came out was really, really shocking, Urvashi. The fact that she was harassed to another level every day. It used to be her in-laws, her sister-in-law, her husband, who would torture her for every single thing. Her entire closet, her bank account, her every single detail was under scrutiny. It was always to be shared with the in-laws first. She has never bought anything in the last 2 years. She had always lived in a kind of fear of the entire family members, and that has been the environment. And we just were also speaking to other relatives who also said that this fear could have been seen every time she used to come home. And that is something that really led to this incident, because nobody here could believe what had happened. And it is just the brutal manner in which this has come to light that has certainly sent shockwaves to the entire family members, who are agitated, who are absolutely devastated, who have lost their daughter. But right now, all they care about is justice, and they want the four accused in this case to be hanged.
Absolutely. This is a unique case, Apurva, because this is coming in from an urban area, Greater Noida. In this case, both husband and wife are engineers. The woman in question, who was beaten up to death, was an accomplished engineer herself, working in a private MNC, as you mentioned. At this point in time, you also mentioned that she has not confided. She never confided in any of her family members all along these 2 years, apart from this one friend. What were the other details, you know, that you can share with us in terms of the kind of harassment she was put through in the past 2 years?
See, right now, the kind of details that's coming out is as simple as when she used to come home after work, she would have had to do all the household chores there, and even after that, she would be really ill-treated, she would be abused, she would be verbally abused as well in a lot of cases. There used to be nobody who would take her side, and she would just endure all of that under the pressure of the society and making sure that the family members really do not feel any kind of a problem there, or they are not really perplexed with this entire incident that is happening with her.
Okay.
But she confided every single detail there with her friend in saying that, I hope things get better.
Mm-hmm.
I hope this should get a little better, but...
All right. Apoorva, we'll come back to you in just a bit to get us to get further inputs on that. Let's listen in to what the doctor, who in fact saw her when she was brought to the hospital, has to say, as well as what the relatives of the victim has to say.
हमारी ये बिटिया जो थी रिचा, हमारे दोस्त हैं, डेंसो में काम करते हैं, उनकी बिटिया की शादी अभी 2 साल पहले हुई थी अल्फा सेकंड में। काफ़ी जो है दहेज भी दिया था उन्होंने, लगभग 30 लाख के करीब खर्चा लड़की वालों को दिया था, बाकी 10-15 लाख रुपए और भी ऊपर से खर्च किया था
जी।
लड़की जो है पढ़ी लिखी है, वो करीब 40,000 रुपये तनख्वाह उसको मिल रही है, विप्रो में यहीं ग्रेटर नोएडा में जॉब कर रही है। और सबसे बड़ी दिक्कत यही थी कि वो लड़का जो है कुछ कमाता नहीं था, और उसको यही जलन थी कि हमारा लड़की जो है इतना कमा रही है, उसको फ्रस्ट्रेशन रहता था। लड़की के साथ मारपीट बताते हैं, उसके भाई ने बताया, लड़की के ने, कि उसके साथ मारपीट करते थे साले।
Apoorva is with us now live. Apoorva, in terms of details, we understand that the husband as well as the girl's in-laws have been arrested, yet the sister-in-law remains to be absconding. That's right. Right now, the husband and his parents, all of them are in police custody. But the search is on for the sister-in-law, who's also been named in the FIR. In fact, it is the sheer brutality with which this incident has come to light that has certainly shocked everyone. The murder weapon, the sharp-edged weapons that were also recovered were three of the weapons, which includes a knife, which included a bat that is essentially used for washing clothes, and a very sharp axe, a kind of an object that is used. And these are the three weapons that were actually used to murder her, allegedly murder her. And that is why the family members at this point are very categorically maintaining that all the four of them should be given the strictest of the strictest punishment for brutally murdering their daughter, just because they did not fulfill the demands of dowry, and also because they feel that the child was far more accomplished than the boy. And that seems to be another reason why there had been a lot of hatred that was spewing between them, and even the family members had been always very prejudiced, and there was a sense of hatred that was there. And all of this seems to have been working through her, and she has been enduring all of this for a very, very long time, only confiding with her best friend and some other friends as well, not even to her father, because she thought that this is too much of a societal pressure that they will have to go through. And she was okay to endure it while she was very accomplished at work. She was a scholar, is what we are even being able told, and also she was studying for IAS. She was going for coachings of IAS as well, because she dreamt of being an IAS officer one day. And all of this just came crashing down for the family members, because when they saw the body, they were absolutely perplexed. They had no idea what had happened, because it was only to the friend that she had confided a lot of these details. The kind of mental harassment that she actually went through is beyond words at this point. Absolutely. Apoorva, personal animosity between the husband and the wife, prima facie, is being seen as the reason behind this brutality that was meted out to this 23-year-old engineer, Apoorva. But we also speak about these 2 years. 2 years ago, they both got married. All along, as you mentioned, she continued to endure the harassment she was being faced. She was facing by her in-laws as well as by her husband. Have you had a word from the family members of the girl? All along these 2 years, were there any feelers that were given out to them of what kind of harassment she's facing at her house.
Well, Urushi, it seems the girl did not really disclose much to the family members, again for the very reason that she did not want them to really be very, very worried about her, because the entire scenario with which she went to her in-law's house, she was very perplexed and she was very, very scared in even saying anything to the family members. But of course, she confided all of this harassment and how the family members would even torment her in not even letting her go to office on some days. They would even torment her for not doing the household work. They would also torture her for not giving enough money to the family members, and her cupboard, her wallet, her debit card, credit card, her salary, every single item was taken by the in-laws, and in saying that it is to be used for her sister-in-law's wedding. So she actually worked for her sister-in-law's wedding, and she could never really purchase anything of her own. She was questioned if she went out to purchase anything of her own. She was questioned if she bought something new for her own. She was questioned and harassed if she bought anything new for her parents. That was the level of harassment that is now coming out, because with these 2 years that she has been enduring, and she's been giving details to her friend in terms of just sharing what is going on, just venting out the kind of problems that she's been through. It is only now that all these details are coming out. But even now, even the friend who we also spoke to is absolutely amazed by the manner in which this has come to light. She did not imagine that it would lead to the husband really going ahead and killing the wife, and in such a brutal manner.
Absolutely. A shocking story there, emerging from Greater Noida. The husband as well as his parents are now under arrest. Meanwhile, search is on to find the sister-in-law. In this case, Apurva, thanks for getting us those inputs.